You said from an early age you had this struggle and everything, and then you try to pray to him and everything, right? And everything to take it away and everything. You see, sometimes when things come, God says He won't give you something too hard for the bear, but it seems like it's hard, and it's like, how can I possibly go through this, right? And then you try to go through it. It's like, when is it going to end? You see, sometimes we see a storm coming and we want the storm to go away, but God's saying, sometimes, you know, the storm doesn't go away, but God says that He'll walk through that storm with you. You see, the Apostle Paul, he says, join ye brethren in suffering for the gospel of the Lord. You see, it's a suffering that takes place to live holy, to live how God wants us to live. But let me tell you, I'm not telling you if you give it up, it's going to be fine, peachy, and a cakewalk. It's not going to be a cakewalk.
It's nothing I can give up.
Well, sometimes we can't do it on our own. That's why we need to rely on the strength of the Lord to get us through. You know, I can't get over, I had strongholds in my life. I used to be addicted to different sin and everything, and I couldn't get through it. I couldn't get through it by my own. I needed the power of God in my life to be able to get through it.
Because God made us all in His image. If you were born a boy, then you were a boy. If you were born a girl, you're a girl.
Why do people say they don't feel like
many of them give us other excuses, like I was born this way, or it's what I like, it's what I prefer, when really the fact of the matter is, God made us in His image. Like I said, if you were born boy, you were boy. There's no change with it. And of course, when it comes to transgenders, they, of course, if they were born a boy and they feel like a girl, they'll go to every height they can to become a girl.
It's like an orange and an apple.
Exactly. An orange and an apple. How do you know an apple is an apple?
All their gods are idols.
Yeah. Like, an apple's right, correct? Now, how do you know an orange is an orange? Is it an orange on the inside, correct? Now, say if you had paint the orange. Is it still an orange or an apple?
The inside
is still
orange.
Yeah, inside, yeah. No matter what you do to the orange, it'll still be an orange, correct?
When you're blind, you don't know
an orange can never become an apple.
Well, one day in the future. We have all this technology.
Yeah, technology can only do so much, honey.
But it's ours. Yeah, but we don't even know. But none of their gods said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So someone came up with a slogan. That's all it is. It's a slogan.
What is the truth?
No, it's not necessarily the truth.
It's either a truth or a lie.
Or it's competition.
How can it be a competition?
There's more than one. How do you know it's the truth? Just because your book and your faith and your tradition and your personal self-belief tells you that it's the absolute truth.
It's the truth because it's the truth.
It's the truth because you believe that it's the truth.
When you encounter the truth, you believe it.
You just believe it with no fact, no evidence.
There's a lot of evidence.
There's a lot of evidence.
I changed your life is evidence. Jesus changed my life. They can change your life too.
The same thing can be said about Islam, Judaism, Hinduism.
Yeah, you're absolutely right, but is it changing it for the better or the worse?
Well, it all depends.
Ultimately, it comes down to what are you going to do with Jesus?
No, it all depends on what you personally want to believe. Jesus is just one of many options of spiritual belief. That's the thing.
The only option. He said, I'm the only way.
And like I said, you're just one missionary competing against religions and other people.
You know how bank tellers tell the difference between counterfeit bills? They don't handle all the counterfeit. They handle the real thing every day. And then when the counterfeit comes across their path, they recognize it. When you handle the real thing enough, you realize.
Like I said, that's a bad analogy. You're talking about something you can really hold. They're holding money, they're looking at it, they're using chemicals.
The Bible says, taste and see that the Lord is good. There is an aspect of tasting God.
You can't put religious belief under a microscope. Like cash.
But you just are. Yeah. You're putting it under a microscope trying to compare tit for tat every little thing that every religion says.
Thank you.
Listen, if I tell you something, you know, I've had so many people come up to me and say, Jesus loves you, do you know that? And I'm like, yeah. I'll just say, yeah. I'm not going to say, no. I'm saying, yeah. Thank you for saying that.
That's why we're out here reminding people that there is a God in heaven who sent his son to die in our place. Because of the sins that we all have sinned, the Bible says, and falling short of the glory of God. But if we continue in that sin, whether it's homosexuality, fornication, adultery, murder, if we continue in those things, and Jesus even said it's the hardest things. If you say you hate somebody, it's like murder in your heart. If you look at a woman with lust in your eyes, it's like adultery. He wants to get at the heart of the matter, which is the matter of the heart. He came to set us free, and like I said, be born again, so we can be transformed into his image.
Not everybody believes they are sinning because they don't have that belief.
And that's the absolute, that's what the Bible says, the God of this world is blind in their eyes. They're blind. They're blind to the fact that the heart is deceitfully wicked about all things. I can lie to myself a lot better than other people can lie to me. You know what I mean? We need an objective truth to pierce our hearts and open our eyes to see the reality of things around us.
So, I'm going to continue living my life the way that I know that God wants me to be happy. I can be happy and not hate myself for something that there's no way to change.
First John 2:16. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world.